We're going to be taking out the tune that was written by the great Nat Adderley and his brother, Cannibal, Julian Cannibal Adderley. Actually, a really great quintet that was very influential in the music. Julian played saxophone and Nat played trumpet. This next piece is called One for Daddy-O. It's written for a jazz DJ in Chicago named Daddy-O Davey. This is One for Daddy-O.
We're going to play one more tune for you before we bring on Solid Brass, and then students will rejoin at the very end of the show. This last piece we're going to play for you is a very important jazz fan, a great Dizzy Gillespie trumpet player, penned this after a trip to Cuba, where he met the conguero, a gentleman named Chango Pozo, and started to influence, very important piece of music, because it started to influence Latin, the Latin side of things into jazz. Before this, jazz was pretty much swinging all the time, and all of a sudden we started to have some Latin influences, okay? Great piece of music. Funny thing is, this has a very cool title. It's called Manteca, okay? But if you look, go to your grocery store, go back to the back, near the butter section, go find the lard, and you'll find out that that's what the Spanish word for lard is, Manteca. So here's Manteca. Thank you.
Thank you.
So that the time frame that I grew up, I mentioned like the 70s. Okay, so I studied with, as most of us do, we study with elders. And at that time, there was this feeling from the jazz community that the Beatles ruined music. Okay, interesting. And I fell into that because I was taught by those elders. You know, even though I heard some of those tunes, I'm just young enough to have kind of caught the tail end of that stuff. You know, but many years later, my kids were young, and if you remember the Nintendo gaming system, we came out with Beatles Rock Band. My wife and I bought that for our kids, and they became obsessed with it. It was amazing. And so we would kind of watch them play. Years later, my daughters and I took a road trip, and we actually played through the entire chronology, and I was hooked, and I realized that those elders were really, really wrong. This music is really phenomenal music, and most of you know that. So, but as an arranger, it's my job to mess with music. So we're going to do Day Tripper right now, but don't try to dance to this, because you'll be a beat. You'll have a beat expert at the end of every measure, every other thing. So this is my kind of rearrangement, derangement, I guess, of the Beatles' Day Tripper. Thank you. very fortunate over the years to have been hooked up with a gentleman in Pittsburgh named Marty Ashby, who heads up a record label called Manchester Craftsman's Guild Jazz, MCG Jazz. And as Randy mentioned, I've been on a few Grammy albums because of him. And he introduced me to a wonderful guitarist named Cheryl Bailey, and we did an album together. And this is one of, this tune is one of the tunes from that album. This tune is originally written by the great J.J. Johnson, the trombone player, very, very well known during the bop era and the hard bop era. It was a beautiful, beautiful ballad that he wrote, and Cheryl decided she wanted to do this as a jazz ball. So here's J.J. Johnson's Lament. Thank you. we're going to go to an original composition of mine. This was on my last album, which was a long, long time ago. In fact, I'm very thrilled. I was telling Brandon, guys, and I'm thrilled to tell you that I actually have a new album coming out after about 13 years, something like that. Some things got in the way. We'll talk about that in the next tune. But this is a ballad of mine that they have equated it to Kenny G. I don't know if that's good or bad. I don't know.
Good? Okay,
I'll take that. Anyway, this is the original one I call the Cyber Plane.
Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate it so much. Thank you. So, I alluded to this a few moments ago, and I need to kind of tell you about something very tragic that happened in my life, just to kind of set this up so you understand what this next tune is about. 12 years ago, my wife was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer and passed away. And any of you who have been affected by that, I feel your pain. We're still working on that. But that set off an interesting journey for me, because for the next 7 years after that, I actually sponsored created a yearly concert in support of pancreatic cancer, the Pancreatic Cancer Action Network. And so it's a very tough cancer, as many of you may know, because it's too late most of the time. And so my wife passed away, and as a lot of musicians do, we emote by writing music. And so my very first memorial concert, I think was literally a day, December 5, 2011, to the day that she passed away. And I actually wrote this piece of music for her. And I mentioned this very sad stuff. I had to tell you that life is beautiful, and life has moved on, and my life is marvelous. We go through these ups and downs. We all know that we go through these. And I just mentioned this because I want you to understand what this piece of music is about. This next tune is called Heaven Sent. And so I chose that title as I was writing this music, trying to figure out what I would call it, what I would say. And I thought about in the old-fashioned way, we think of heaven sent, you know, and again, the youngsters don't even know this, but some of the old folks out there my age, we talk about someone being, you know, if you have a mate, you say, my mate has been heaven sent from heaven to me, you know. So I thought I would turn it around and see what a voyage to heaven might be like. I thought about what it would be for my wife to take her voyage to heaven. So this is called Heaven Sent. Thank you. for you is my career, I've been very lucky to do a lot of stuff for the publishing companies. So a lot of high schools and junior highs have played things I've written. So this is one of those pieces, and the band decided they wanted to do this. This is a sort of a younger band thing, but I'm very called Alegria. Thank you. So I get, I mentioned the publishing company, so I get some really great assignments sometimes from the publishing company that surprise me. And way back, whenever, let's see, I just had an initial listen. So I was raised Catholic. So in the old days, again, kids are not going to relate to this, but the parents and that and relate to this. So all the new cartoons came on Saturday mornings, right?
Okay. Yeah.
As a Catholic kid, I never got to see those because I always had like CCD I had to go to. Okay? But in the summertime, man, I always enjoyed it. It was great. Okay. So, but one of the coolest things that we didn't realize whenever we were kids, and whenever we were watching Spider-Man, we were listening to one of the hippest jazz tunes, man. The Spider-Man theme from Spider-Man is a minor blues. And so the publishing company, my boss called and said, we want you to do an arrangement of the theme from Spider-Man. I was actually thrilled. There you go. Here's the theme from Spider-Man. Thank you. I want to take a minute to thank Randy for helping put all this stuff together. Thank you so much, man. It was huge fun. Thank you, man. We appreciate it. Thanks. Appreciate it.
Have a day for you.
Also, a hand for the band. This band is marvelous, man. Solid Brass. And really quietly, all the All-Star students on stage. You're ready to do our last piece of music. So we're going to do a great piece by the group Power of Power. That doesn't mean so much to in the ground. Just a second to set up. We have a massive stage setup here.